I moved to LA a year ago. It was in August 1st. I remember like yesterday. Moved. I had my green hat still on. Came out here. I went straight to I went to Fairfax. Shed a couple tears because it was a huge transition from where my friends were at. And like, you got to think when you're, you know, going into a situation where you don't know what's going to come of it. You know what I mean? Just moving out to LA out of nowhere or anywhere. You know what I mean? To pursue a dream. It's like, you don't, you're taking a gamble. So I'm doing, you know, cartoon TV show.
That's so bad. Why did you spell hate birthday? It's happy birthday. Happy, not hate. No, it's a great cake. Great cake.
I'm doing a lot of like merchandise stuff as far as like my branding with Action Figure Miles. I have like my vest that I'm, you know, releasing t-shirts. I'm trying to turn that into an entire brand instead of just merchandise. You know, acting, incorporating all that stuff within the music. Everything kind of coincides with like the action figure or like the, you know, just the overall aesthetic that I'm going for.
Doorbell. I know you see the Benz outside. I know you wanna see what's inside.
So as far as like the characters, Miles, which is, you know, me, Rocky Miles. And the reason I actually made that character is because like it was off my album Depression. So we were just sitting back and like we were thinking about different like moods or whatever and what colors set a certain mood. And I felt like blue, and this, I like the aesthetic and I wanted to grow that character. So just knowing that I've been using like more cartoonish like art for like the past few years, I was like, okay, let me just continue doing this. And then let me just actually bring this art, the character to life. So that's what I ended up doing for Dante's Toys, and that's Miles. You know what I mean? So it's like a raunchy version of like Toy Story. From Baltimore, but I didn't stay in the scene in Baltimore as much, you know what I mean, as I was in the Delaware scene. And I would throw, you know, events out there, and I started to become like well known just from those events, which were called Weird and Awful. It was based in Delaware, and I developed that company from, you know, from scratch because I just felt like the area that it was in, as far as like, you know, the Delaware area just didn't have like a music scene, and it wasn't being serviced even if there was a scene. Something that I felt set creatives and people that are trying to do something different aside from the crowd. And that's basically what, you know, Weird and Awful meant to me.
I met a lot of fans and they bought a lot of merchandise, and I made new fans too through my performance, and it was just great meeting new people. Rakim is a really nice dude. Like, he gave me that opportunity and I'll forever be thankful for him.
Every year has been sold out. I've never had like a Weird and Awful show that hasn't been sold out within the venue's capacity. Things are, you know, crazy. Like the show that I just had with Waka, that's one of the biggest shows we've ever had.
I just want to make a noise for a fucking legend, man. I swear to God, I believe he's gonna be a legend.
When I was back home a year ago, I was working in a warehouse. You know what I mean? Working in a warehouse. I got mad one day and I started punching the tires. And I was like, yo, I'm done with this. Like, I was extra mad. I started like touching my chest, beating my chest and everything, pulling my hairs out of my chest. I only got 3 hairs. So I felt really upset about it. And it was just like a really weird experience, like seeing me like frustrated at that time, saying that I was gonna like get to the next step, and then all of a sudden, a year later, I'm actually where I said I was gonna be when I was at that job. You know what I mean? I just kept saying it over and over again. I'm gonna move to LA. I'm like, my coworkers, like people that are around me, like, oh nah, it's gonna be too hard for you to do that. I'm like, nah, I'm gonna figure it out. They're like, yo, you know it's expensive, right? I'm like, all right, cool. I never thought that I would never have to work again, but I would always say that. Like, I don't wanna ever work a regular job again. I wanna just do music, and I wanna have music full time, and I don't wanna do anything else but work on music. And like, out of nowhere, it's like working out that way. Since I know it's gonna have an impact on people, and like, I'm just not personally the person that's gonna like put out bull crap or anything. I want them to like walk away with like, yo, this helped me. It got me through hard times. You know what I mean? At the end of the day, I know that's like, that can sound like mad preachy, but at the end of the day, I just personally feel like there's people that are going through stuff. There's people that, you know, need that type of music.